As many of you probably already know, I've been living in Bengaluru now for more than 3 years. And if I'm being honest, it's my favorite Indian city. But when it comes to startups, Bengaluru is a bit of a black hole. It just sucks up all of the nearby entrepreneurs and startups and VCs and venture capital and accelerators and incubators. And as a result, the rest of Karnataka gets less attention than it probably deserves. But what a lot of people don't realize is that Karnataka actually has a rich and thriving startup ecosystem outside of its capital city. And so in this video, I'm going to be highlighting that ecosystem by sharing with you Karnataka's top 10 startups that aren't based out of Bengaluru, coming up right after this. So starting things off at number 10, the first place that we're going to visit is the heritage city of Mysuru, which is where husband-wife duo Harshavardhan Kikkeri and Shwetha Harsha chose to start their virtual reality startup, Kaaya Tech, back in 2016. Now, if you've ever seen the movie Ready Player One, then you already have a decent understanding of what Kaaya Tech is working on. This is a wireless motion tracking and capturing suit called HoloSuit, which makes virtual reality experiences more immersive and productive. Now, like in Ready Player One, HoloSuit can be used for gaming, but Kaaya Tech is actually focusing more on other use cases like employee training and education. Their suits come with haptic feedback and dozens of sensors that allow Kaaya Tech's customers to run specialized employee training simulators in domains like agriculture, automotive manufacturing, electricity, healthcare, and more. Next up at number 9, we have another Mysuru-based startup, this one in the edtech space, Kidvento, which was one of the winners of Startup Karnataka's Elevate 2018 awards. Founded by Nikhil, Bhaskar, and Sumanth, Prabhu in 2017, Kidvento partners with schools to offer what is essentially a curriculum in a box. You get everything: textbooks, workbooks, tests, teacher manuals, lesson planners, the whole deal. And what's great about Kidvento is that alongside all of this offline material, they also provide their partner schools with a robust online platform where teachers can host live classes and post videos, collect assignments, interact with parents and students. And it's this combination of online and offline that makes Kidvento such an attractive proposition for the more than 350 schools that have partnered with them so far, especially during this COVID-19 pandemic where online learning has become so essential. Moving on to number 8 now, we're going to make our way over to the education hub of Karnataka, Mangaluru, where another edtech startup called MicroDegree is based. The startup was founded in 2019 by Gaurav Kamat, Manikanta Nair, and Rakesh Kotari with the goal of teaching coding through online courses to people in the language of Kannada, which is the official language of Karnataka. It's really a simple concept, but it's also a powerful one. For people who don't speak English or Hindi, learning to code can be tough. So having a dedicated platform like MicroDegree opens up so many possibilities for the more than 43 million people who speak Kannada as their primary language. As of now, more than 5,000 people have signed up with MicroDegree, and the startup is backed by Mumbai-based 100X VC and Research Innovation Incubation Design Labs, along with Indian angel investor Sitar Somaya. Coming in at number 7 now, we're going to make our way up to a city that is fondly known by many as the temple town of Udupi, or Odipu if you speak Tulu. And it's here that we'll find a fintech startup called UDMA Technologies. The startup was founded by Prashant Naik back in 2016 and began its journey with a digital wallet called the Use Anytime Anywhere wallet. This UAA wallet, unlike normal digital wallets, can actually be used without internet. See, in order to approve transactions, banks require you to send them authentication data. And this is normally done using 2G, 3G, or 4G. But for people living in rural parts of India, a reliable mobile internet connection can actually be pretty hard to come by. And that's where UDMA Technologies comes in. Instead of using the internet, they compress authentication data into a single encrypted SMS message, thereby circumnavigating the internet entirely. This offline technology caught the attention of Yes Bank, and in 2020, UDMA Technologies partnered with them to launch Yuva Pay, a digital payments app with a lot of the same features as other digital payments apps like PhonePe, Google Pay, and Paytm, but with the added benefit of offline functionality and transactions. Next up at number 6, we're gonna travel to one of India's first ever smart cities under the Government of India's Smart Cities Mission, Belagavi, where a water filtration startup by the name of Nirnal is making waves. Nirnal was founded in 2016 by Niranjan Karagi, who identified a need for affordable and clean drinking water in India when he saw children filling up their water bottles at an outdoor tap. This tap, of course, was unfiltered. And it was at that moment that Niranjan came up with the idea for a small water filter that would fit into a standard plastic water bottle. Fast forward to today, and Nirnal is selling these small water filters for just 30 rupees alongside more premium filtration products. So far, Nirnal has sold more than 2 lakh units to customers in over 15 different countries. Moving on to number 5, we have another Belagavi-based startup, this time in the IoT space called SenseGiz, which was founded by Abhishek Latte and Apurva Shetty in 2013. Now, on the consumer technology front, SenseGiz is known for their wearable armbands called Safer, which function as sleep and fitness trackers and can also be used as safety devices which notify family members in the event of an emergency or accident. But these armbands are actually just one piece of a larger IoT ecosystem that SenseGiz offers their enterprise clients. With this hardware, SenseGiz can track assets and employees, detect perimeter intrusions, and also establish bio bubbles for COVID-19 free sport tournaments like the 2021 Road Safety World Series in Raipur and the BCCI India versus England Test Series. Coming in at number 4, we're gonna make our way over to the opposite side of Karnataka now, to a small town called Sanduru, which is located about an hour and a half outside of the steel city of Karnataka, Ballari. Sanduru is home to AI-Bharata, an AI startup that was founded in 2019 by serial entrepreneur brother duo Vinayaka and Vivek Jyoti and Sahana Malapanahalli Shivaswamy. And this trio has built a system called Myra, which uses AI and ML to detect and differentiate between 15 different lung and chest disorders, including pneumonia and COVID-19. It does this by analyzing chest x-rays, and while it's still in the prototype phase, it's being used by multiple hospitals across India and was showcased at NASSCOM's 2021 Technology and Leadership Forum. Next up at number 3, we're gonna head over to the last city on this list, Hubballi, which is arguably the second most exciting startup hub in all of Karnataka after Bengaluru. And this is thanks in part to one of the city's incubation centers called the Deshpande Hubballi Sandbox. And it was here that our next startup, Freshboxx, was incubated. Founded by Archana Saxena, Pawan Patil, Praveen Narapanavar, and Rohan Kumar Kulkarni in 2015, Freshboxx delivers fresh fruits and vegetables directly from farms to their customers. They started things off as a strictly B2C company and were initially getting just 10 orders per day. But as the years have gone on and Freshboxx has continued to grow, they've continued to serve those individual customers, but they've also managed to onboard more than 150 retail partners, including Reliance, Nilgiri's, More, and Big Bazaar. Moving on to number 2, we have another Hubballi-based startup, Skykrafts Aerospace, which is a drone startup that was founded in 2015 by Srinivasulu Reddy G. So far, Skykrafts Aerospace has created drones for a number of different use cases. They've built an agriculture spraying drone, an award-winning cardboard drone intended for DIY tinkering, a more generic drone for enterprise and government use cases like research, surveying, and inspection, and an open source blockchain UAV traffic management system called Skyware, which allows for the tracking of drones and the enforcement of drone-related laws. For their innovations, Skykrafts Aerospace was selected as one of the winners of Startup Karnataka's Elevate 2017 awards. And finally, coming in at number one, we have another Deshpande Hubali sandbox incubatee, PublicNext, which is a hyperlocal social media news app that was founded by Manjunath Rao and Vishal Seth in 2017. PublicNext empowers its users to take on the role of news creators by reporting on the things that are happening in their neighborhood or district, posting job opportunities, and sharing their opinions on social issues, all in their native language. Their monthly active user base is upwards of 20,000 people, mainly located in the Hubali-Dharwad region, and for the time being, these users are exclusively using the app in Kannada. But the startup plans to expand their reach by providing PublicNext in other languages as their user base grows. For their efforts, PublicNext was selected as one of the winners of Startup Karnataka's Elevate 2019 awards. Hey, you made it until the end of the video. Thank you so much for sticking around until the end. And to show our appreciation, we wanted to include one honorable mention that didn't make it onto the list because they were acquired by HCL in 2019, but we thought that they were worth mentioning anyways. Sankalp Semiconductor, which is a Hubali-based company that was founded by Vivek Pawar in 2005 and is currently one of the largest independent analog and mixed-signal semiconductor design service companies in India, with offices in the United States, Canada, Japan, and of course, India. But when Vivek started the company, it was just a team of 6 people. Even way back then though, Vivek was on a mission. And unlike a lot of entrepreneurs, it wasn't to make a bunch of money. Instead, Vivek says that my only intent was to create centers in tier 2 cities of India in order to enable inclusive growth. Sankalp Semiconductors is a small step towards that. However, since those early days, Vivek has furthered his mission significantly. He set up an education and training company to make college students job-ready called Eklakshya. He founded the Abdul Kalam Sushandi Fellowship Program for high school-age students to receive a free education and later obtain internships and employment. And today, he is the CEO of Deshpande Foundation. He's just one of those entrepreneurs that you can't help but feel inspired by. Which is why we decided to wrap this video up by talking about him and the company that he helped to build and eventually sold. All right, those are the top 10, or I guess I should say top 11, Karnataka startups that are not based out of Bengaluru. And before we wrap this up, one more thing to note is that this list was not organized from worst to best or least valuable to most valuable. It had nothing to do with revenue or funds raised, but instead, we treated this list almost like a road trip, where we started at Bengaluru, and then we traveled to Mysuru, and then we traveled all through the state until eventually reaching Hubali. And if you're from one of the cities that I mentioned in this video, or you currently live in one of those cities, then definitely leave a comment down below, because I know that a lot of our viewers are based out of Bengaluru. It's the Silicon Valley of India, which is why I'm here as well. But we would love to hear from you if you're from somewhere else in Karnataka. Also, if you enjoyed this video, then it would mean a lot to us if you could hit the like button. And if you haven't already subscribed, now would be a great time to do so because we post new videos every single week about Indian startups, entrepreneurs, and the latest news. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Backstage with Millionaires, and I will see you in the next one.